Hey, it's Ramzi. In today's video, we're going to talk about the 5 biggest mistakes people make when they start on ClickUp. Avoiding these will save you a ton of headaches down the road. Make sure you stick around till the end, because the last one will lay the foundation for everything else. Now you're ready? Let's go! Now the first massive mistake is creating way too many items. This is probably the thing I see the most often when I land on a client workspace. I see workspaces with 10 different lists that each only have 3 or 4 tasks. Now we could group all of that into a single list by using tags and a custom field, for example. Another typical example is having tons of lists with views that no one ever uses. You create a calendar view or a board view and no one uses them. It's just a total mess. And you usually end up in this situation when you let all users create fields, views, and other ClickUp items. One pretty radical but effective solution is to upgrade to the business plan, which lets you lock down permissions. Or even better, you can get the enterprise plan and it lets you create super customized roles and gives exactly the right permissions to the right people. Now that's probably the best option to regain control. But if you can't afford any of these premium plans, what I recommend is to set up a request system in your ClickUp workspace. That way, any new item creation has to be approved and monitored by 1 or 2 ClickUp champions on your team. The role of these champions is to be gatekeepers of the ClickUp temple, making sure there's no clutter or duplicates, nothing is unused. Now that was the first mistake to avoid. The next one is not applying project management best practices in ClickUp. I'll give you 5 project management mistakes so you get 5 errors in one. So first off, make sure every task starts with a verb and is written in an actionable way, with a clear description and requirements. Next, you have to break down the big tasks into subtasks if they need to be done by multiple people. That way, everyone knows exactly what they're responsible for and it drives accountability. I see way too many tasks with 4 or 5 assignees and in the end, no one moves. Third point, don't use temporary statuses like waiting for validation or to send if you don't really need them. A status should represent a state that lasts over time, not a mini action that takes a few minutes. It might be controversial, but sometimes you don't even need an in-progress status. For most teams, 3 to 4 well-thought statuses are enough, even with a super complex workflow. Then tags. Don't misuse tags. I see teams tagging everything for any reason. They even tag the people assigned to the task instead of using the assignee field. That brings me to the last project management practice, fill out the task fields properly. ClickUp has built-in and custom fields for a reason. So get in the habit of filling in at least the time estimate, the start and end dates, and of course the assigned people. Creating this habit is very useful when you start using advanced features like capacity planning or dashboards. Now, to save you some time at Upsys, we systemize a lot of this with templates and automations that act as safeguards against the mess. And if you want to know more, reach out to me for a call. The link is in the description. A lot of people think project management is about opening up a task, assigning it to someone, and closing it at some point. But ClickUp's real power is in the collaboration tools. You have a ton of features that allow your team to work together, efficiently, async, and remotely. The activity feed on the right side of a task, for example, lets you see the complete history and updates of a task. And you can see the assigned comments. You can give mini tasks within a task and notify people directly without clogging up Slack or Teams with the assigned comments. It's so much easier to manage actions when they're contextualized within tasks rather than having someone harass you with messages every 5 minutes in your company chat. If you set up notifications properly, all your task updates will show up in your ClickUp inbox. Now it will become a single point of contact for the team. You will only use Teams or Slack to share a joke or some memes or some general communication. Make sure you fully understand and leverage these awesome built-in collaboration features that are in ClickUp. That's really where the power of that software lies. Mistake number 4 is not mastering ClickUp security and customization settings. If you work with freelancers or if you have teams that shouldn't see certain strategic info, it's super important to understand permission management, task sharing, user roles, A typical example, you can create a confidential list with your high-level tasks and delegate action items using a feature called Tasks in Multiple Lists. That way, your team or freelancer can see only the subtasks for that very high-level strategic action. Another example, with the right permissions, you can allow users to add tasks but not delete them by just giving them edit-only access and a form view to submit their tasks. So basically, ClickUp offers insane flexibility and settings for security and privacy, but you need to take the time to properly set it up and train your team on it. We're getting to the last point, which is probably the most important of all. It's a bit less related to ClickUp directly, but trust me, it's the foundation for everything else. And this final mistake to avoid, and probably the most crucial one, is to think that ClickUp will magically solve all your organizational problems. Spoiler alert, it won't. A tool, even the best one in the world, cannot work miracles on its own. For ClickUp to truly be useful, you first need to have clear and well-defined processes within your company. ClickUp is just a tool. It's an awesome tool for sure, but it's still just a tool. It's there to streamline your communication and ease your collaboration between your team, especially if they work remote or async, but it can never magically fix messy processes. The key is to start by getting your own house in order first. Clearly define your goals and processes, and once that's clear, then you can properly set everything up in ClickUp. And your team will also need proper formal training to really embrace the tool. Because if you go halfway, if no one buys in the system, you're going nowhere. There you have it. Now it's time for you to do a full audit of your company's workflows and workspace. I bet you that you've committed at least one of these five mistakes. But don't worry, ClickUp is super flexible. We can fix anything quickly. If you need help with this, at Upsys, we offer ClickUp audits and expert consulting. We can help you remove duplicates, optimize your structure, your automations, get everything up to standards. So if that interests you, just book a discovery call through the link in the description. In the meantime, you can also download a checklist that covers all the important aspects to setting up ClickUp. Thanks for sticking around. I'll catch you on the next video. Stay productive.